welcome back to my channel, Savvy Street DIYs with Shanice. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you how I created my wooden slat shower floor. So if that is something that you're interested in, then go ahead and stick right here. Okay, so let's go back in time just for a brief second to the summer 2020 when I decided to renovate one of our bathrooms in our home. The renovation did include me using a tub and towel refinishing kit to sort of update and spruce up the dated towel that we had in our shower. After this, I still felt like the bathroom was just falling a little flat and needed a little bit more oomph. And don't we all want a spa-like feel in our bathroom? I know I do. So that is when I did a little research and Google searches on the internet, and I came across these wooden slat floor mats for the shower. And on CB2's website, they're roughly about $75 to $100 and above that. And for the size that I needed for my shower, it was definitely gonna put me over the $100 threshold. So I decided to make it on my own. And I actually created this, and it has been in our shower since September 25th-ish, something like that. But I wanted to wait for it to have some wear and tear before I actually shared this video with you, just so that I can give you more feedback. And I also wanted to share this DIY with confidence and encourage you to try this at home for your shower as well. So let's go ahead and get into the video. And before we get into the video, if you are not subscribed to my channel, I would love to ask you to subscribe. This is my space where I share all of my budget-friendly home decor and DIY projects to transform our house into a home. If that is something that you are interested in, then go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I will do my best to share a video weekly. I know with work and different things, I have not yet fulfilled that commitment, but I do plan on getting a lot better with that. All right, just before we get into the DIY, let me share with you the materials that you'll need, and I will post them on the screen somewhere, I don't know where. But the materials that I used: wood glue, 1.5-inch screws, 2x2 teak. I use redwood, but you can use any 2x2 with using cedar, teak, or redwood, and this can be purchased at your local Home Depot or Lowe's. I did find it teak was kind of hard to find though. You will need 2 1x2s in the same type of wood that will be cut the length of your shower, and you will need spacers. Now, I didn't use spacers. I tried to like rig it some type of way, but the spacers will come in handy when you're trying to screw everything together. And at the end of the video, I will share with you how everything is holding up. I'll share with you how I clean. I'll show with you in mold and mildew, and you know, some people said the wood was gonna rot and all this other stuff. So I'll share all of that with you at the end of the video. So if you want to get information on that, or my take on it, or how mine has been holding up, then stick to the end of the video and I will share that. So without further ado, I feel like I've been talking and talking and talking. Let's just get into this DIY. Good thing it is in like hyper speed or time lapse, whatever you call it, so that we can get through this quickly. Let's go. All right, so come with me to my local Home Depot where we are going to pick up our wood for this project. Again, like I said earlier in the video, you can use cedar, teak, or redwood. I went with redwood because the teak selection was very slim. Here we go. When I was picking this wood, I tried to pick the slates that were mostly a lighter color, not so red. All right, now that I got the wood back home, the first thing I did was take the 1x2s and cut them in the length of my shower. No point in giving you these measurements because your shower measurements may be slightly different from mine.
And you will need to do this twice. And these are basically going to hold your slats together. Now, the next thing that you want to do is you want to take your 2x2s and you want to cut them in the width of your shower stall. And I kind of subtracted about a half an inch just to give it some side room. Preference, not mandatory. And now that we have all of our wood cut to the dimensions of our shower, we want to line them up and place the spacers in between each slate. This is the part where I told you, use the spacers, get the proper spacers, because see, I'm trying to space them here with just some wood that I had and I didn't have enough of it. And yeah, it was a struggle. Also, important to note that with this redwood, because it has so many variations in color between the red and the kind of like pine white, I tried to place most of the lighter side face down when putting this together because I wanted the lighter wood to be face up. Now that I have the slats in somewhat the appropriate spacing and in the dimension that I needed, I went ahead and used some wood glue to secure my 1x2s to the slats. I let that dry for about 30 minutes and I drilled a couple pilot holes in a zigzag fashion so that I would not split the wood. And from there, I just secured the slats to the 1x2. And again, I did use a zigzag pattern because I did not want this 1x2 to split. And that is basically it. And voila, here is the slated mat that I created. As you can see, I wanted most of the lighter wood face front or face up in the shower, and I did the best to try to like get the matching wood color in there. So let's put this baby in the shower. Also, really quick to note, I did go over this with 220 grit sandpaper. This wood was already pretty soft and smooth. It didn't require a lot of sanding. If your wood needs some sanding, then go ahead and do so.
So, as promised, I want to make sure I address a couple of common themes, these reoccurring questions that sort of I've received about this project. Now, if you have a more detailed question or you have another question about something that I did not address in the video, leave me a comment and I'll get back to you. So the two things that I want to address is the type of wood and sealant, which I didn't use any sealant, by the way, but I've been asked why not. So I'll address that. And then also the cleaning and upkeep of this, having it in the shower. So first things first, the type of wood and why I chose not to seal it. So you can use teak, you can use cedar. Teak was actually my first choice, but it was hard to find. And I ended up using redwood. Now, these three types of wood are typically used on outdoor projects like patios and decks because of their natural ability to withstand weather, water, mold, mildew, and be mold mildew resistant. So that is why you want to make sure if you're going to do this project, you want to use one of those three types of woods. Sealing it is not necessary, especially because it'll be indoors. I do practice, you know, leaving my shower door open once a week, maybe once every other week, opening the window, or, you know, just to air out our bathroom in general, just to get some good air circulation. The wood has been holding up just fine. Like I said, it's been in since September. It is just as strong as the day that I put it in there. It is not rotting. It is not withering away. It is not, you know, I don't get any splinters. It's not breaking apart or anything like that. It is just as strong as the day that I purchased this wood. So for me, if you don't want to add any more chemicals into your bathroom, it is not, for what I've experienced so far, it's not necessary. And even what I've read about the wood online, it's also not, it's not really necessary. So I chose not to seal it. The second question that I'll address is the cleaning of this. Now, when I did my research, it said that you can clean it once a month, take it out of the shower, you know, put some bleach on it, scrub it, and then power wash it to get rid of any soap scum and different things like that. Now, for me, that's just not enough cleaning. I typically clean the shower once a week. I clean it with that slate in there, with that slate floor in there. All I do, bleach and water solution, a brush. I brush the top of it with the bleach and water solution, and then I kind of lean it, prop it up on one of the walls, and I spray the backside with some bleach and water solution, give it a nice scrub, use my shower head on the strongest spray setting possible, and then kind of power wash it off. Do the same, you know, with the bottom of the shower, just as you generally would clean your shower. And I have not had any issues. There has been no mold. There has been no, well, because I clean it so often, there has been no mold. I mean, no like soap scum buildup, just because, again, I clean it pretty frequent. And I mean, I haven't had any issues with it. And so again, one of the reasons why I decided to wait some months before I even shared this project was just to kind of like get a gauge of what and how, what the upkeep looks like and how the wood is gonna hold up over time. So again, it's been 4 months, but I think that's a good enough gauge to let you know. And I mean, if you have questions, you can always like follow me on Instagram. And if you have a question about this particular project, or even leave me a comment here 6 months from now, and I'll let you know what's going on with it. But that pretty much, I think, covers most of the common questions that I receive about this project. And I guess that's it then. So bye for now. Into our next video. And if you are still with me to this very end, thank you so much. I truly appreciate your time. I know that is means a lot. Your time means a lot to me, and I know that your time means a lot to you. So bye until our next video.